Here's the question that we are going to investigate today. First, we have a 3-4-5 right triangle, and we are going to put a rectangle inside. And the question is, what's the biggest possible area of such rectangle? And the rectangle is going to be like this. One of the vertices has to be on the hypotenuse, so I can put it down like this. And then just draw it downward, and then you are just going to have the base right here. And then you draw your rectangle. So this is just a rectangle, but if you put the point right here, maybe right here, you draw another one, they are going to have different areas. And we would like to know what's the biggest possible area that we can have. So what do we do? Well, of course, you can kind of guess and check. You can say, because the whole thing is 4, so maybe I want to go from here to here, make it 1, and then find out the height, and then compute the base times the height for the rectangle, length times width, and then find the area for that, and then maybe go from here to here, let's say 1.5, and then find out the rest, and then find out the corresponding height, and compute the area. But that takes too long, of course. Here's a systematic way to do it. We can use algebra for this. Firstly though, in order for us to use algebra, we need an equation. And in order for us to get an equation, we need the x and also the y-axis. So I'm going to put on the x-axis right here on the base, and I'm actually going to have the y-axis right here. So that way you can see this right here, the line has 0 for the y-intercept. And the slope is up 3 to the right 4. So we can write an equation for that real quick. It's just y equals 3 over 4 for the slope times x plus 0. So that's the equation. Now, here are two really useful words that will help you to solve situation, work problems, application problems. The first word is know. We are going to first put down what we know. And based on our picture, and you see that we know the connection between x and y is y equals 3 over 4x. That is what we know. Next, we are going to put down what we want to know. Well, the question is, we want the maximum of the area of that blue rectangle. So let's say this right here is the area. And we will have to come up with an equation for this though. So how do we do it? Here's the deal. Be really careful with it. When we have the x-axis and also the y-axis here, you cannot just label from here to here to be x. No. Because this right here is the x. Okay, that right there is the x. Since the y-axis is right here, from here to here, it's the x, because we're using this x and y system. But it's okay, because if this is x, since the whole thing is 4, so that means this much will just be 4 minus that much. It's just 4 minus x, okay? Then, because from here to here is x, if you have a point right here, right, an x value, it can go up, and you can get the y value. So that's just y. The height. Again, either you look at this as the base times height or length times width, but the height right here is just the y. So now, for the blue rectangle, all we have to do is this times that. So we have 4 minus x times y. And have a look. We know this, and we want to get the maximum of that. Let's go ahead, put this right here for y, so you can see we'll just have a as a function of x. And if we distribute it, then you'll see that this is going to give us a quadratic. 4 times 3 over 4, the 4 cancels, so we have 3x. And then negative x times that is just negative, and we have the 3 over 4 x squared. And as you can see, this right here, the coefficient of x squared is negative, so the parabola opens down. So that means we have a maximum at the vertex. So here is a quick note for you guys. When we have a parabola, let's say anything in general like this, written in terms of the standard form ax squared plus bx plus c. The vertex here has a nice formula. It's at x equals negative b over 2a. And when we have a coefficient in front of the x squared being negative, it opens down. So you can see this right here, you will have a maximum. And that's exactly the situation that we have. So let me just put this down again, but I will put this down first. And then we can use the vertex formula. So I will just write down the maximum will be at x equals negative b, which is the 3, over 2 times a. A is this, which is negative 3 over 4. So that's negative 3 on the top over this and this cancel. So that's negative 3 half on the bottom. And you see the negative negative cancel, and then you can multiply the top and bottom by 2. So this and that cancel. And then you can see that the 3 and 3 cancel. So just work that out, you'll get just a 2. Okay, a lot of things cancel, which is pretty nice. And maybe some of you guys noticed this already. In order to achieve the maximum of the area for the rectangle, you go halfway, which is a pretty nice. That's like next cut, right? Anyways, though, if x is equal to 2, we can put this back into this equation. So we know y is equal to 3 over 4 times 2. And that will just be, after you multiply this, you get 3 over 2. And to answer the question, if we want the maximum area of such rectangle, when x is 2, from here to here is 2, that means this much is also 2 because it's halfway. But technically, you should put the 2 right here for the area. So the maximum area is just 4 minus 2 times y, which is 2 over 2. And this right here is 2. The 2's cancel. So the maximum area of such a rectangle they can put inside of this triangle is 3. Unit squared, right? So this is a pretty cool question, I would say, and also pretty standard pre-calculus slash calculus question. If you're in pre-calc, then you're supposed to do something like this. If you're in calculus, then you will have to do the so-called derivative in order to get this value. And in fact, I can show you guys how to go from here to the maximum by completing the square, but I'll do that in another video. I do have a very interesting question for you guys though. This time, we are going to pick a point right here on the hypotenuse, so somewhere here, and then pick another point on the base right here, let's say somewhere here, and then pick one more point somewhere here. I will just draw it right here. If you have a triangle inside of a triangle like this, we want the minimum area of such triangle. And you might be wondering, why don't we do the biggest? Well, the biggest is the blue triangle itself. You just put this point right here, you put this point right here, and put this point right here. Okay? But the minimum one is the one that you can think about.